This is a short video about a sieving application of a typical flour sample with an Analyzet 3. We have several sieves for separating the sample, and what we want to do is now to using the Analyzet 3 to separate this sample into fractions and analyze this afterwards with a checking the balances or the masses of each sieve. For analyzing the sample later, after the sieving procedure, it is important to note the empty balances of the pan and the whole sieves. So we will do that. Put the pan on the balance, note the empty weight, and put the next one after Tara, the next sieve on top, note it again. And as you can see, we use also sieving aids, which are 5 of 5 millimeter agate balls to separating the sample. Now we can put the whole sieve stack on the Analyzet 3, and we can put the sample of 100 gram blue horse, this is the green horse sample, flour sample, on top of the iced sieve. All sieves have, like I said, 5 of 5 millimeter agate balls as sieving aids to avoid electrostatic loading. Now we can put the lid on the whole sieve stack and fix it. Now we can set up the whole parameters of the Analyzet 3, which includes the amplitude. We work typically between 1.5 and 2.5. For very fine samples, we choose a very high amplitude of 2.5 millimeters. The sieving time is 10 minutes, and we work without interval mode, so permanently mode. We can start now the sieving procedure. After the sieving test, we will open the sieve stack and take a look if the sieving procedure is completed. The first sieve does not include a lot of sample. The next one is a little bit more tricky. But I think the sieving procedure was successful. Now we go the reverse way and start to balance the whole sieve stack with the pan and the sieves, and we note the balances, and the difference from the empty ones is then what in reality was the sample. With the masses on the sieves, we can now create a graph which will show us the sieve curve of each sample.